हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ लवलीन टिल्लो. आई एम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीएससी एग्रीकल्चर सेकेंड ईयर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन आंवला. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग आई लाइक टू थैंक आवर कोर्स इंस्ट्रक्टर डॉक्टर प्रशांत बख्शी फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. नाउ वी स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट देयर आर माय कंटेंट्स ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन दैट आर इंट्रोडक्शन, टेक्सोनॉमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन, इम्पोर्टेंस डिस्क्रिप्शन, कल्टीवार्स, सॉइल रिक्वायरमेंट, क्लाइमेट रिक्वायरमेंट, कल्टीवेशन टेक्निक्स, वाटर मैनेजमेंट, अदर प्रैक्टिसेस लाइक ट्रेनिंग, प्लूनिंग, मल्चिंग, इंटरक्रॉपिंग, न्यूट्रिएंट मैनेजमेंट, पेस्ट ऑफ आंवला, डिजीजेज ऑफ आंवला, हार्वेस्टिंग एंड यील्ड, क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड आंवला. फर्स्ट स्लाइड इज हेयर इंट्रोडक्शन. Botanical description. Scientific name of amla is Amblica officinalis Gattan. Family Euphorbiaceae. 2N is equal to 28. Polyploids with 2N is equal to 98 to 104. Its origin is tropical southeastern Asia, particularly central and southern India. Fruit type is berry. Amla is also called as Indian gooseberry. Its edible portion is placenta. Next, the taxonomical classification. Kingdom of amla is plantae. Division is flowering plant. Class is Magnoliopsida and family is Euphorbiaceae. The order of amla is Malvicales. The tribe is Phyllanthiae. Subtribe is Fluth. Genus is Phyllanthus and the species is Amblica. Next, the importance. Amla is a rich source of vitamin C that is 600 milligram per 100 gram. It also used in making murabbas and chutneys. The other products are sauce, candy, dried chips, tablets, jelly, jam, pickle, powder, etc. The fruit is also used in preparation of hair oil, which is very good for our hairs. It can also be used in Ayurvedic for preparation of Trifala and Chyawanprash. It also help in healthy blood circulation. Next is description. The tree ranges from small to medium in size, reaching 1 to 8 meter, that is 3 feet 3 inches to 26 feet 3 inches in height. The trunk is slightly curved and the branches are scattered around. The bark of amla plant is gray with hard reddish wood. It has yellowish green or pink color flower. Fruit, pale yellow in color, round in shape and has 6 vertical strips. A ripened amla fruit is hard and weight approximately between 60 to 70 grams. Leaves. The leaves is lighter in weight, linear and longer in shapes and smells like lemon, and leaflets are arranged in pinnate shape. Fruit color. The green color changes to light yellow or brick red in maturity. Odor is odorless. Taste sour and astringent. Now we talk about the cultivars. First is Chakaya. It is a prolific bearer. The fruits are small to medium in size, weighing about 26 gram, having a TSS of 10.7 degree Bix. Trees are spreading in nature, alternate bearer and free from necrosis. Another one is Banarasi. The fruits are larger in size with characteristic 3 raised segments. Each fruit weighs approximately 38 gram. It is a shy bearer and best cultivar for murabba. Krishna, and it is also known as NF4. The fruit is medium to large size, having weight 40 gram, having red bush on the exposed surface. It is fiberless, which is semi-transparent and hard. It is moderate bearer. Next is Kanchan. which is also known as NF5. It is a profuse bearer with small to medium sized fruits, which having weight 32 gram. The seedling selection is from Chakaya. The another one is Francis. The fruits are large, about 41.5 gram with weight and a TSS value 12.0 degree bricks. It is almost fiberless in nature and suffer from severe incidence of fruit necrosis. Next is BSR1. The fruits is medium in size and with 27 gram weight with a flight styler and round calyx end. Each fruit has 6 segments. The juice has a TSS of 18.1 degree bricks. There are some other cultivars like NA7, also known as Neelam, NA6, like known as Amriti, that is ideal for amla candy making, and NA6, Gujarati amla, Balwan, Lakshmi 52, Goma, Aishwarya. These are the pictures of the cultivars like BSR1, Chakaya, NA7, Kanchan and Krishna. Now we distributed them in the regional, national and international varieties like NA6, NA7, Banarasi, Chakaya, Francis, NA10, Desi. These are the regional varieties, and on the other hand, national NA4, NA5, NA6, NA7, NA9, NA10, Banarasi, Chakaya, BSR1, Francis, Balwant, Lakshmi 52, Gujarat, Amla, Anand 1, Anand 2, Anand 3, Goma, Aishwarya. These are the national varieties, and the international varieties include Glendale, Oregon, Camp Champion, Careless, Hinon, Makis Yellow, Early Sulphur, Telegraphy, Winham's Industry, White Smiths. Now we start with the soil requirements. The soil is light and medium heavy. Avoid poorly sandy soils. The tree is well adapted to dry regions and can also be grown in moderate alkaline soils also. Maximum soil pH is 9.5. Then the climate requirements. It is a tropical plant, needs annual rainfall for about 630 to 800 mm, that is ideal for its growth. The young plant up to age of 3 years should be protected from the hot wind during May June and from frost during winter months. The mature plants can tolerate freezing temperature and as well as high temperature up to 46 degrees Celsius. Best temperature for growth and development is 25 to 35 degrees Celsius. Next, the cultivation techniques. Planting time of amla is from July to August, and planting is like dig pits of 1 meter cube during May, June at a distance of 8 meter into 8 meter. Then leave the pits for 15 to 20 days to the exposing sunlight. Each pit should be filled with surface soil mixed with 15 kg FIM and 0.5 kg of phosphorus before planting the grafted seedlings. Amla is commercially propagated by patch budding. Time of patch budding is May to August, also propagated by seeds. Tea budding is also used in July. The flowering time is Feb to April and the fruiting time is July to September. Now, water management. Young plants require watering during the summer months at 15 days interval till they are fully established. Watering of bearing plants is advised during summer months is bi-weekly interval. After the monsoon rains during October to December, about 250 liters of water per day per tree through drip irrigation should be given. Now the other practices are training and pruning, leaving only 4 to 5 well-shaped branches with wide angle at about 0.5 meter from the ground level. other that diseased weak crisscrossing branches and suckers should be pruned off at the end of the December. The system of training and pruning is modified central ladder system. Next is mulching and intercropping. During summer, the crop should be mulched with paddy straw or wheat straw at the base of the tree up to 15 to 20 cm from the trunk. Intercrops like green gram, black gram, cowpea and horse gram can be grown up to 8 years. Next is nutrient management. At the end of first year, 20 kg of farmyard manure and 30 kg of nitrogen should be applied. Additional 30 gram of nitrogen also added in the early year. For bearing tree, 800 gram of nitrogen, 640 gram of P2O5, 750 gram of K2O with 30 to 40 kg of FYM applied in every rainy season. In irrigated conditions, these dose is split into two doses. One should be applied during April to May when the fruit is set and then irrigated. The another dose is applied during the September to October. Next, we discuss about some of the important pests in Amla. First is mealybug, that is Nipicoccus viridis and Nipicoccus vastator. The symptoms of this pest is new shoots are found bending and twisting with yellowing of leaves, severe infestation, twigs become leafless and dry. To control this pest, we should prune the affected parts and destroy them at the early stages. Then spray spinosad 0.25 ml per liter and quenelphos 0.05%. The next pest is Amla aphids, that is Staphylococcus bougainvillea. The symptom of this pest is infected leaves become yellow and dry, shoots appears bended and twisted. Presence of ants also indicate the infestation of aphids. The control is clipping off and destruction of affected leaves and shoots. Then spray dimethonate 0.06% or spinosad 0.25 ml per liter. The next is leaf rollers, Gracilaria acidula. Symptom of this pest is webbing of leaves, their withering and dropping. Heavy infestation leads to the drying of leaves and dropping of leaves, then leading to drying of twig also. The control of this pest is avoid overcrowding of branches, clipping of rolled leaves and destroy it with larvae. Spray carbyl 0.2% or chlorpyrifos 0.04 or quenelphos 0.05%. The another pest is stone borer, Curcula species. Symptoms is ovipositional site appears as small brown patch on the fruit. The infested fruit may also be identified by the presence of exit hole. The control of this pest is spray of carbyl 0.2% or quenelphos 0.05% at a pea size of fruit. Spray same solution for second time if needed. Now we talk about the diseases of Amla. First is Amla rust. It is caused by Ravenalia amblicae. Amla rust appears as circular or semicircular reddish solitary on leaves from the beginning of August. The control is spraying with diethane Z78 at the rate of 0.2% at the interval of 10 to 15 days during the months of July to September proves effective. The next is blue mold. It is caused by Penicillium islandicum. It develops water-soaked lesions on the fruits, which is ultimately covered by bluish green pustules as you see in the picture. The control of this disease is the treatment of fruit with weak solution of borax and sodium chloride. The another one is fruit rot. It is caused by Penicillium oxalicum. The symptoms is water soaked lesions on the fruit surface which enlarge in size, followed by the development of small pinhead type colonies on the golden yellow color. The control of this disease is fruits showing symptoms should be discarded, bruising during harvesting should be avoided, and fruits can be treated with wheat, borax and salt solution. The next one is bark borer. It is caused by Anderbella tetraonis and Anderbella coordinotata. It makes the tunnel along the barks. Control by injecting kerosene oil in the holes and plugging with cotton and clay during September to October and Feb to March and spraying with phosphomidone 0.1%. Next is shoot galls. It is caused by Hypolampris stylophora and Betiosa stylophora. The control is by pruning of the affected shoots and spraying 0.1% monocrotophos. The next we discuss about the harvesting and the yield. Amla tree starts bearing after 2 years of planting. The fruits harvested during the Feb. When they become dull greenish yellow from light green, the mature fruits are hard and they don't fall at gentle touch, and therefore vigorous shaking is required. The fruit can also be harvested using long bamboo poles attached with hooks. The average yield is about 150 kg per tree per year. The average weight of fruit is 60 to 70 gram, and 1 kg contains about 15 to 20 fruits. A well maintained tree yield up to an age of 70 years. Next, we discuss some questions related to amla. First is vitamin C content of amla is about how much of edible portion? That is 600 milligram per 100 gram. The second question is amla commercially propagated by which method? And the answer is patch budding. The third question is what is the planting time of amla? And the answer is July to August. The fourth question is which type of training and pruning method is used in amla? And the answer is modified central ladder system. What is the flowering time of amla? And the answer is Feb to April. The next is planting distance of amla 8 meter into 8 meter. The seventh question is which is the best cultivar for murabba, and the answer is Banarasi. The eighth question is at which stage irrigation should be avoided in amla, that is flowering. Another question is which is the major bark eating caterpillar, and the answer is Anderbella tetraonis. The last question is what is the proper propagation time for amla, and the answer is mid-May to September. Thank you everyone for joining me.